girlfriend trapped him. Then he goes, oh, what's it all for? Why am I here? The same thing, the girl, she's just for her boyfriend until he leaves her. Then, oh, what's the purpose of life? What's it all for? Someone exists to be a doctor or an engineer, okay, until that lets them down. They don't get what they thought their life was for. And then they suddenly realize that, no, that's not the purpose of existence. That's not the purpose of life. So when you ask them that, don't let them give you some answer like, no, I want to achieve that. Say, no, I'm not asking you what you want to achieve in life. I'm not asking you what you want to do with your life. I'm asking you, why do you exist in the first place? Why are you and me here as human beings? Why? Because doesn't everything have a purpose? Think about it. Everything has a purpose. Everything has a reason for which it exists. I'll ask a simple question. This. See this what I'm holding in my hand? Can you all see it? Huh? What is it? What's it for? So it has a purpose, right? I have something else here. I have something, what's this? Yeah, it's actually a Catholic calculator watch. Oh, no. It's a watch. And what does a watch do? Right, you see these things I'm pointing to here? Actually, underneath these things there. What's that? What does it do? Okay. Listen, if you think about everything, your eyes, your ears, your mouth, your teeth, your toes, your hands. If you think about every single individual part of your body, you will find every bit of it has a purpose. It has a reason for which it exists. The pen has a purpose. The watch has a purpose. The sun and the moon and the stars and the trees and the animals all have a purpose. What is our purpose? Why are we here as human beings? Ask that question. What is the reason for our existence? And some people, most people will look at you, they'll go, you know, like, what? No one ever asked them that question before. And it's amazing because this pen made a plastic worth what? 30 cents? 50 cents? It has a purpose? And you don't have a purpose? You mean the pen is worth more than you? Because the pen has a purpose and you don't. Your watch has a purpose and you don't. Your sneakers have a purpose and you don't. So maybe you're worth more than even the clothes on your body. What is the purpose of the human being? And then the other question comes. How are we ever going to find the answer to this question? How are we going to know the reason for which we exist? What way are we going to employ to find out? Well, to cut a long story short, there's only one way you can know. There's plenty of ways to get, but there's only one way to know. And the only way to know the reason for which you exist is when the one who gave you existence, the one who created you, who knows you better than you know yourself, when he tells you, I created you for this reason. Now, I only know one book, and believe me, I have studied many books about many religions. I only came ever across one book that told me definitely, clearly, the reason why I existed, and that is the Quran. And the Quran says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنْسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Allah created the human beings and the jinn only so they should worship Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. That they should worship Allah. That means, let's put it in black and white, simple language. I exist and you exist for one reason. And that is to worship Allah. You don't exist for any other reason. Allah didn't mention any other reason for your existence. He created you only for that reason. In fact, anything else you do in your life is a waste of time. In fact, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the world and everything in it is cursed. The dunya, the world, and everything in it is cursed. Meaning Allah's mercy has been removed from it, except the scholar of the religion, the student of knowledge. The student of knowledge of the religion and the remembrance of Allah. The remembrance of Allah and everything that helps you to do that. Everything in the world is cursed except the scholar and the student of knowledge and the remembrance of Allah and that which helps you to do those things. Because we have been created to worship Allah. And what is ibadah? What is worship? Worship can be defined as, and this is one of the best definitions of worship, every action, whether it is of the heart or the limbs, which is an action that is loved by Allah and is pleasing to Allah, that is worship. Every action that is loved by Allah and is pleasing to Him, whether of the heart or the limb, that is an act of worship. So our purpose in life, brothers and sisters, may Allah have mercy on you, is not sex, drugs, and rock and roll. It's not just eating and drinking and living and working and playing. The purpose of life, the reason for which he exists, is to try our utmost to make every feeling, every belief, every thought, every action, everything we do with our hands, with our feet, everything we say with our tongue, everything we look at, everything we listen to, something that Allah loves and is pleased with. That is the purpose of our life. And worship encompasses all of those things. And you know what? What is so fantastic? We are so lucky. You know what? We don't have to guess how to do it. Imagine! DHL not on your door. You've got DHL in here, right? You know who DHL is, right? Imagine a postman knocks on your door and he opens it and he gives you a big parcel. And you open it up and inside is something you've never seen before. You don't know what to do with it. So you look at this thing, it's got maybe some plugs and some wires and some bits and pieces. It looks very interesting. So you're looking through the box, and what are you looking for in the box? What are you looking for in the box? The instructions! Because without it, you don't know how to work this thing! Allah, He sent us the instructions. He said, this is the purpose of your life, and here is how to fulfill your creative purpose. That's why He sent messengers. That's why He sent the Quran. That's why He sent His last and final messenger, Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to teach us how to worship Allah, and who is the better worshiper of Allah, and who is the better example of how to worship Allah than the Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So He sent the Quran, and He sent us the explanation of the Quran. He sent us a perfect example, so we could try to follow and emulate. So that we wouldn't have to guess how to fulfill our created purpose. Oh, brothers and sisters, think about that. Allah has put up the reason for which he created